We were all born into love and of love on a world formed of love by whatever loving cosmic force decided this third stone from the sun would be hospitable and loving to our kind of biological, chemical, and sentient life. Love is in the blessing of gravity and the Van Allen belt. Love is in the grace of the ionosphere and the atmosphere and the radiation absorption
and the radiation absorption of the ozone.
We are breathing in love as we speak.
We are breathing in love as we speak.
Nitrogen in a mixture of 78%
nitrogen,
20% oxygen,
argon, 0.93%.
So the love was shown by this earth has an air of benevolence about it that is enduring. We can also speak about the love of our mother's wombs, how that love carried and nurtured us for 9 months, held us in its aqua boogie until we were ready to pop out and take our first breaths on this Mother Earth, in the cycle of this wondrous life.
Scientific equation, trust times effort plus lust times passion. So in lieu of your absence, I admit that I mentally DVR'd our holidays in Aspen. The details in the snowflakes, rain in the cabin, Monet over the fireplace, the Everclear the absent. You stay, I look away so I don't telegraph the message. You know what's on my mind, you're telepathically obsessed with the way humans communicate. You illuminate the room like the moon harvest. Regarding the fact that I live my life as a starving artist, you support the god regardless on his path to be a novelist, marvelous with the nourishment. I admonish the monogamous way you astonish me with your encouragement. My therapist, so much merriment, it's so effortless that I should share your magnificence with the world. You already gave me so much, but I'ma keep it just for me.
Infatuations, those are truly our own to behold and mentally possess. They have not been operating without us on a cosmic scale long before we were ever in the mix. We tend to become infatuated by choice, and the intensity of those choices may sometimes seem like love of a sort. But you can ask nothing more of an infatuation than that it merely tolerates your presence in the room. You can make yourself needlessly suffer for an infatuation, martyr yourself to that suffering, but that won't be love. Because love would never be so indifferent to your love or your suffering.